Hello, good to see you again. You may wonder which portals are currently used to make government data available to the public, and what are the key elements and the various forms of these portals. In this video, we will be exploring these topics. After this video, you should be able to define open data portals, to describe their key elements and forms, and to give some examples of open data portals. So how can we define portals for open government data? A portal should be seen as a place where the user can gain an overview of the available data. You can compare it to a web shop that shows potential clients which products are available in its online store. It shows which data sets are available at which places. The portal is in between the end user and the data provider. And just like a receptionist or a traffic controller, the portal directs the citizen or the client towards the right place, namely the place where the desired data can be found. Through open data portals, governmental organizations can give citizens and other open data users access to their data. The portals can be owned and maintained by governments or by other actors, such as foundations, which may publish processed government data. Both types of portals can give citizens insights in open government data. And a portal is the first place to start looking for open government data. The data itself is usually not stored in the portal, but through the portal, the user can get access to the data and the tools and the services to use the data. Citizens can find data through a variety of portals and can then use the tools and services to analyze, visualize, and otherwise use the data. Existing open data portals differ with regard to their key elements and forms. They have different functionalities. On most governmental portals, only government agencies can upload data sets. Some other portals also allow others to make data available or to upload processed versions of governmental data sets. The existing portals also reach out to different user groups, have different objectives, and publish different types of open data. For instance, some countries focus on economic benefits of publishing and using open data, on businesses and entrepreneurs as data users, and on data that are expected to stimulate the development of innovative products and services. Other countries focus more on objectives such as transparency and accountability, on researchers and citizens as data users, and on data that creates new insights and allows for holding governments accountable, such as budget data. While some portals are simple, others are more advanced. The simple portals are cheaper to produce, but require more work and effort from the side of the user. The more advanced portals usually provide more user support, but they are accompanied with higher costs. The desired form of the portal depends on the goal for providing the data. For instance, if user experience and high uptake are seen as important goals for making government data available, a more advanced portal may be developed. And since many portals are available to find open government data, the user can select the portal of his or her preference. Most portals only aim to make data searchable and findable. They do not store the actual data sets, but they link to places where the actual data is located. There are a few reasons for this. The main reason for not storing the actual data is that the provision of one single data set at multiple places is avoided. The data sets then do not need to be maintained and updated at a variety of locations, and in this way, the risk that multiple or old versions of a single data set become available is reduced. Moreover, when portals do not store the data themselves, they require less storage capacity, Storing many and big governmental datasets can require quite some storage capacity. And in addition, portals that do not store the data, but that only refer to places where the data can be found, do not need to be updated as often as portals that do store the data. The updates will take place at the location of the data itself, and the links to the data at the portal need to be updated occasionally. A disadvantage of not storing the datasets at the Open Data Portal may be that the data are provided in many different forms, since each data providing platform has its own characteristics. For instance, one platform may provide data in a certain format, while another platform uses other formats. And this heterogeneity may complicate the use of the data. Metadata, or data that describes the data, is often used to make government datasets searchable and findable through open data portals. The ability to find governmental datasets depends to a large extent on the quality and the quantity of metadata. There are many metadata initiatives going on to make data more easily searchable and findable. Furthermore, technologies such as application programming interfaces or APIs and linked data can be used to make data more easily searchable and findable. APIs provide an interface to access the data, and linked data allows for relating chunks of data to each other. Open data is made available through internet-based portals by governments from all over the world, and different forms of open data portals exist. There is a diversity of portals, but there is no best portal, since each portal has its own goals. Some of the portals cover a variety of countries. For example, the United States government provides an overview of its data on the data.gov portal. Some portals concern the data of local governments. An example concerns municipalities providing overviews of their data. For instance, the municipality of Amsterdam does this through amsterdamopendata.nl. In addition, various governmental agencies have their own open data portals, such as the portal of the Dutch Meteorological Institution, KNMI, about weather and climate. In addition, there are portals offering processed open government data, such as publicspending.net. This portal offers processed open data from sources such as government data portals and DBpedia, and it analyzes, corrects, interlinks, and depicts the data. In sum, many open data portals are available to make government data searchable and findable. And the portals exist in various forms. They often direct open data users to the places where the actual data can be found. In the ideal situation, underlying tools and services can then be used to analyze, visualize, and otherwise use the data, and to derive useful conclusions. Thank you very much for your attention.